beautiful, dark, silent night. With the fog creeping in. Time for you to awaken, Master. Time for you to go out.
Jump about like this?
Oh, Lady Ainsley, I'm so bad. Grandpapa brought me with him.
We've been playing war, sir. Nikki was a German and I killed her.
I hope he didn't kill you very much, darling.
Don't you think it's about time you were in bed, young man? Or don't soldiers sleep?
Of course they do.
May I play one piece on the piano before we go to bed?
Please.
Very well, then. Just one.
Oh, Ray, come, Nikki. We can be writing in the tape until we get there.
I'm sorry to interrupt you, milady. It's quite all right. We'll be up later to tuck them in.
In the beginning of time, man has been troubled by the uncertainty of death and by the rare and horrible manifestations which occur at intervals in which the dead are known to return from their graves.
An animal?
No, Jane, not a bat. A vampire. A monster. A fantastic something that draws blood from the human body through the jugular veins of its victim. This thirst for blood is akin to all craving for food. Without human blood, they perish.
Yes. Did you hear what we were talking about?
No, sir.
Here come the Jerrys.
You'd better call Nicky. I shall want her for any cash.
Look at this place. It's getting so it ain't even safe to be dead.
Right.
Well,
I ain't going to do nothing with him.
The king expects every man to do his duty.
Well, why did they have to shove this blinky job onto me?
Well, I don't know. But
look, don't do this.
A blasted spike sticking out of his chest.
You know, it ain't right for a man to be buried decent and proper like and then go and get hurt by a blooming bomb splinter. That spike's got to come out before we bury him again.
Yes.
Horace, pull it out yourself.
Chicken-hearted is what you are.
bury him and get it over with.
Yes, but which is his grave?
How do I know which is his grave? He ought to consider himself lucky to have a grave.
Yes.
Come on. Right. Let's shove him in the blinking hole.
Andreas, have you ever heard of Dr. Hugo Bruckner?
Bruckner? Oh, yes, the famous scientist from Heidelberg. He's a prisoner in some German concentration camp.
He was a prisoner. The underground are slipping him across the channel tonight. They want me to make the same arrangement as with the others.
A fool. Your fate is to be what you are, as mine is to be what I am. Your master. Come. Complete understanding of fear psychosis is essential if you want to control the mind of another.
Sort of mind over matter business, what?
Precisely, Sir Fleming. The mind is the greatest of all human forces. Mm. Control the mind, and you control the body.
Who are you? Why have you forced me to come here?
You read your father's manuscript. Look at me, Nicky. Now tell me who I am.
You are Armand Tesla. But Tesla's dead.
I am. Tesla, and I can never die, and you are mine forever. But before I take you away from here, there are many things I will make you do for me. Then you will go with me to my native country, where no death can claim you or tear us apart. Your mind is no longer your own. I shall command, and you shall obey. Look at me, Nicky. Look at me. Look at me.
I understand from the caretaker that you are the two gentlemen who helped clean up the cemetery after the big blitz.
Yes, we are that, Mum.
Were many of the bodies disturbed?
Well, maybe half a dozen, Mum. More or less.
Do you remember seeing one of an old man, a very old man, with a spike in his heart?
Yes, we do, Mum. But how did you know?
Can you tell me what became of him?
We pulled the spike out, Mum.
Did anything happen while you were pulling out the spike? Or afterward?
Yes, it did, Mum.
We heard a sort of gasp. A low moan. But it couldn't have been him. Or could it?
What happened then?
We buried him again, Mum. All nice and cozy like.
Could you show me where?
Yes. Here we are, Mum. Blimey.
He's upped it.
Lord love a duck. Who'd go and steal a dead corpse?
Where did you get that ring?
I found it, Mum. It was laying there in the dirt. Is it yours?
Mine? Oh, no. No, it came off the corpse.
Here, Mum, have it with my compliments.
Pardon me, Mum. I gotta go with Horace.
Nicky, your eyes. I never saw them so queer. Stop staring at me like that. Nicky!
Nicky.
sun is going down, isn't it? Oh, if I could only hold back the night, keep it from getting dark. That's when I hear those voices whispering to me, telling me what to do. Oh, if there were only some way to stop this terrible thing. Lady Jane, you've got to help me.
I will, darling, I will.
Be quiet! Be quiet!
I'll die. You must not let that happen, Master. You promised me life eternal, like yours forever.
I no longer need you, Andreas. Your usefulness is over.
You must not say that, Master.
Get away from me.
Idiot. Get back to that corner. Remain there. Die. There is no power great enough to keep you from me. I have won.
One of them, Andreas. Doesn't look much like a werewolf now, does he?
He isn't now. Poor Andreas. He found his soul after all. May he have peace forever.
But who this blighter is, I don't know. He looks to me more like a bundle of rags and bones. Looks as if he'd been lying there for some time.
That, my dear Sir Frederick, is all that is left of Armand Tesla. Now, do you believe in vampires?
Dear Jane, must you go back over all that?
Very well, then. If it isn't Tesla or Bruckner, perhaps you'll tell me who it is.
Say, you fellas don't believe in this vampire business, do you?
Yes, sir.
We do.
And do you people?